So I thought we could chat for a few minutes about what you're looking for in a Westworld experience. We know it can be difficult to name the things that you want. They're right on the tip of the tongue, just out of your reach. So we have a few questions we'll have us think outside the box. Maybe shed some light on the thing that's always been there. And when we're done, we'll know each other better.
Okay.
Will this be your first time at Westworld?
Yes.
Welcome. Have you been to a luxury resort before?
No.
Okay, your very first time. Now, imagine a portrait of you is being created. It can be in any medium that you like. Sculpture, film, photography, painting. What artist would you choose to create?
Van Gogh.
Bulgers. Now let me ask you, what percentage of your dreams would you characterize as nightmares?
1%.
Now, if someone told you and a group of others that you could alleviate the world's problems just by pressing a button, but pressing that button would also halve the world's population, would you press the button?
No.
Would you ask someone else to press it for you? Or would you destroy the button and the button's creator?
I'd destroy the button and the button's creator.
Interesting. Look at your hand for me, if you would. Imagine you found yourself in a dire situation and you had to part with one of your fingers to save yourself. Which one would it be?
Pinky.
Great. Just take this marker and make a nice big X on that pinky.
Would you mind? I'm sorry, opening
it? I can, of course.
Yeah, thank you. Actually, could you do the...
Sure, if you're comfortable with that.
Yeah, that's fine. Thank you.
Fantastic. One final question. Imagine yourself in a saloon. A gang bursts in through the door and kills two innocent people who are sitting with you. They then turn to you. They offer you a gun. Do you join them? Do you fight them? Or do you refuse them?
Fight them.
Another bold choice. So they'll hear your answers. It's fascinating. You have a vibrant, independent mind, don't you? You're strong-willed, but you're not unhinged. You can be pragmatic when you need to be, but you're also something of a rebel. A dreamer. Perhaps even an idealist, which is a difficult thing to be in the world today. You're diligent, you're determined, you're often underestimated, but you're very capable, aren't you? You avoid pretense or subterfuge, you demand that in the people who surround you. Do you often feel like one of the smartest people in the room?
No.
No? But better than average mind. But for you, that's probably a double-edged sword because you put a lot of pressure on yourself. You have a great capacity to bring stability and balance to those around you. I'm sure not everyone sees that, but those who do probably look to you for support or sometimes for leadership. You're down to earth, but you have an imaginative side. There's an artist inside you. You probably don't spend a lot of time daydreaming, but when you do, I imagine it feels incredibly liberating. Especially for an idealist. Seeing the difference between the way the world should be and the way it is, reconciling those things, carrying around the burden of the weight of that knowledge is exhausting. So it's nice to have an escape. It is very easy to be trapped in worrying about what you lose. If you decide to let go and live in your fantasy. But at Westworld, we believe everyone deserves to live without limits. Just for that. Stand up for me, Blue.